Hey everyone, I'm Brian Mackey, Product Manager for Ensight, and I'm here to give you an update, really a roundup of all the features and functionality we've added and improved over the past year or so. Just looking back on 2023, and we've produced a lot of functionality and upgrades, including improvements to core features such as batch management and automation, the integration with SentinelOne. We've updated how we integrate with Cove. We have improvements to Apple device management, and not to mention also the introduction of the EnableMe portal and a resource center with easier access and discovery of all those really valuable resources as well. So let's just start with some updates to core features. We improved automated tasks so that they now run in near real time. It means that as a technician and you're trying to run a script or resolve an issue for a customer or maintain devices, you can run those tasks and see the results more or less right away instead of waiting on the next check cycle. We have also made updates to patch management, lots of updates actually. So it's now possible to use auto approval rules for Microsoft patches in a much more granular way than before, using Microsoft's classification of patches. So you can determine which patches you want to automatically deploy, which ones you want to manage manually as part of your service. And this also extends to third-party apps. Again, more granular settings available to you through the auto approval rules for patch management. Additionally, we've added support for out-of-band patches, and this most recently includes support, for example, for Server 2012 devices. If you still have those, they're out of support with Microsoft, but they are still delivering security patches, and it means that you're able to deploy those patches through the patch management workflow as standard, as opposed to having to script or do something bespoke in order to handle Server 2012 devices, as an example of our integration with patch management and Microsoft patching. Further improvements to the antivirus update check, where we're now working or supporting really the Microsoft Security Center, makes for a much more scalable antivirus update check compared to just selecting individual products from the third-party apps that we support in the AV update check. We're working on the next improvements to make it handle Windows Defender better so that it doesn't trip that checkup as much. We have updates also to network discovery, and just recent few weeks we've been rolling an upgrade out in the background, so it now discovers many more devices on the networks that you manage. We also improved fingerprinting of Windows and Mac OS operating systems, and we have better detection of manufacturers. We've added more support for third-party manufacturers that you discover on the networks that you manage. In addition, to make it easier for you to see the assets under management, we added the new asset inventory view, which has very intuitive column filtering, sorting, search functionality, and for the first time really makes it very easy for you to filter and search for devices by model, manufacturer, serial number, processor, and we'll be adding more to that view in the months ahead, including some new summary charts that we're just putting some finishing touches on just now to help you understand even more quickly what devices you have under management, which you can then export to CSV for customer-facing reports, for example. You can also link to the North pane and look at those devices you've filtered over an asset inventory to maybe run scripts or address some issue that you want to solve for those devices. Let's take a quick look at our integration. So we updated our Cove integration so that we are basically offering you the full access to all of Cove functionality, but you can still monitor Cove through the Ensight dashboard, and we have some more improvements planned in the coming year in that area. The big upgrade, of course, was to SentinelOne and our service for EDR through Ensight. So now you can deploy the EDR agent through the Ensight workflow, but then go directly to the S1 console to take advantage of all the functionality on offer there, including, for example, deep visibility or Ranger, which allows you to detect devices on networks that do not have the S1 agent that that you might want to protect with SentinelOne. So some significant upgrades in that integration with SentinelOne, and we're seeing a huge amount of success with that. Speaking of SentinelOne, Apple devices now also support S1 thanks to that upgraded integration. For Apple devices, we now support app management through our integration with Apple Business Manager. So you can actually lock down which apps can be installed on Mac workbooks, on iOS devices, Apple, iPhones, iPads, etc. We have also updated how you can manage macOS version upgrades. You can now do that directly through the N-site UI. You can select different modes of upgrading. You can install the downloads and update the macOS version there and then, or you can let the end user do that at a time that suits them. So lots of enhancements in that space also. Last and very much not least, we have introduced the resource center. That's the area you see top right. And through this notification area, we can highlight when we have new release posts. We can highlight when we have new scripts that are added to the automation cookbook in the brand new EnableMe portal and all the resources that are available to you in that space also. So lots in 2023. We have many things still on the go. And we very much look forward to bringing you more updates and upgrades in 2024. As always, to find out more, go to the status blog where we post all our updates in full Technicolor with screenshots, etc. And of course, we'll highlight those now also in the resource center so that you'll get a notification essentially when we do have updates coming out so that you always stay up to date. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel so you stay up to date with all these videos that we produce. Thank you very much, and we'll see you again in the new year.